Hi guys, so I am filming another empties video or products I've finished, products I've used up, whatever you want to call the video. I love doing these videos because I get to talk about stuff that I have totally finished. I can give you an honest opinion on what I think about it, and I can tell you whether I would bother spending my hard-earned money to purchase these things again. So let me show you. I've got the container, I've got my normal container of like stuff. It's probably like half full. But a couple of people were asking me to do the empty video, so I thought, it doesn't matter if I've only got a few things, I'll just do it, and then I'll just start saving again. So first thing I want to talk about, because these go hand in hand, is the Fibrology Thickening Shampoo and Conditioner. The reason I didn't make a video, like, straight away about these is because I wasn't that impressed with it, and now it's just leaking all over me. It kind of says, having fine hair is not a result of having few hairs, but each strand is significantly thinner in diameter than normal hair. Therefore, it seems like there is less of it, lacks grip, becomes flat, and is difficult to do anything with. What if science could give you thicker hair than nature did? I don't understand how that works. I just don't get it. I think whenever you wash your hair, you blow dry upside down, you get like a certain amount of volume. And I agree, I get the same volume when I use this shampoo as when I use like a totally normal hair shampoo. And it always claims to make the appear, like make the hair appear thicker. So it doesn't actually make the hair thicker. So how does it make your hair appear thicker? I don't know. I don't really think any of it is true. I think it's a gimmick. The only thing I absolutely loved about this shampoo is the smell. So based on that, it's not an expensive thing. It's not really expensive, and it's not something I wouldn't consider purchasing again. I just don't think that what it claims to do is entirely accurate. But I did really like the smell of it. So that is my shampoo and conditioner, and they're wet, and I've just thrown them on the bed, and that's gross. The next thing I have finished is my Cetaphil Gentle Skin Cleanser. I think this really helped my skin. What I was doing, I was using this to wash my face with in the morning, and then I was using something that more exfoliated my face at night. This is what I was using in the evening. So when I get home from work or when I'm in the shower, I use my Pink Grapefruit Daily Scrub as like my face wash in the evenings or when I'm in the shower. But every morning when I got up, I didn't want something like abrasive. Bearing in mind, I didn't have any makeup on while I was sleeping, so I just needed something to clean the skin like properly in the morning. So this I used to use at night, this I used to use in the day. At the moment I am using two different face washes again. So I'm using the Bior charcoal face wash in the morning because it doesn't have grainy bits in it, and for the evening I am using a L'Oreal exfoliating face wash. Both of them I absolutely love, and I will definitely make another video of those when I repurchase. I think at the moment how I'm going to decide which ones I buy, I'm just going to see which ones are cheaper or which ones are on offer or which ones I can get 3 for 2, because I think these are both fantastic and I would definitely use both of these products again. But I am kind of just liking the Bior charcoal face wash a little bit more than this for the morning, because it just smells really nice and it has like that kind of mentholy feeling, which I really, really like. So yeah, and plus there's a little bit more, I think, product in the bottle, so it just lasts me a little bit longer. So both of these face washes I absolutely love, but I tend to use a different one in the morning to what I use in the evening. And like I said, those are my reasons for it. I need something a little bit more abrasive in the evening and something a little bit more gentle in the morning. So both of those I would definitely repurchase again. Next thing is a dry shampoo, because it's just gross. Do you know what I realized? When I have dry shampoo in my room, I tend to wash my hair less naturally, just because I think, oh, it's fine, I've got some dry shampoo in my room. So I didn't repurchase this, even though if I was going to repurchase, I would definitely use this one again. But I realised how lazy it was making me, because I knew I had dry shampoo in my room, so I would purposely not wash my hair thinking this would save my life. And I ended up getting through this really, really quickly, because as you know, I can't leave my hair down unless I've washed it. So on the second day, I was pretty much already having to use dry shampoo, and I just refuse to wash my hair every day because, number one, it's so much hassle, and people keep telling me that it's not good for me. Not good for my hair. So I've purposely not repurchased any dry shampoo because it forces me to wash my hair. Like, I'm so disgusting. I can't believe I'm admitting this on the internet. But dry shampoo is not something I'm going to buy again. I'm just not, because I just don't wash my hair as much, and I just think that's disgusting. So yeah, but if I was going to purchase it again, I would definitely get the Batiste one. Next thing is a Johnson's Face Care Face Wipe. This is great for lazy days when you've got a full face of makeup, you come home and you just think, I can't be bothered to use like a cleanser and blah, 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 blah. So get the majority of your makeup off with one of these bad boys. And then what you need to do is wash your face as normal with your normal face wash. Because sometimes when you've got like really heavy eye makeup and stuff, this actually removes quite a lot of it. It leaves like a little bit of pandery eye, but that's fine because my face wash will normally get rid of that anyway. So these are great. I bought like three of these because they were on sale and I'm still getting through the other two. I don't use them that often. I just use it for like really heavy makeup days when I'm really, really tired. Next thing I've got is the Olay Anti-Wrinkle Cream for Sensitive. I bought this ages ago. And I told you once I finished it, I would do a review on it. I don't think I would buy this again. It doesn't smell that nice. Like, and you know how I am without smells. Like, I have to stop saying this in every video. But if it doesn't smell nice, I don't really want to use it. And the problem when I bought it, it was in one of those, like, container boxes. One of those plastic boxes. And then it had, like, a bloody tag on it. Like, someone was going to steal it. And I was like, it's £5. It's face wash. It's not really expensive. Why is it in a tagged up box? So I bought it. I didn't realise that it was going to smell a bit funky. So I bought it. I don't think in terms of wrinkles it really did anything. It didn't make my face feel any firmer and it smelt weird. So, I mean, yeah, I'm still up for using the whole anti-wrinkle stuff. But if it doesn't smell nice, I really don't want to put it on my face. That is not going to be a repurchase. The next thing is just a small deodorant, which I carry in my bag for if I'm going out with my boyfriend, going out with my friends, and I'm going to be out for the whole day. I do feel the need to have a little can of deodorant with me. So I do have another one as backup. So definitely always repurchasing little cans of deodorant to keep in my handbag. Next thing I absolutely love, and this I would definitely repurchase, is my dual heat protection by Aussie. I use this loads when I go on holiday. When I'm just lying on the beach and I'm not doing anything, I'll put loads of heat protectant spray in my hair just to keep it like looked after. It smells really good and obviously it's like leave-in and it smells great and it's really yummy. It's not expensive, but if it smells good, it's definitely something I don't mind being near my hair. I bought like two or three of these. I also love the Aussie leave-in spray conditioners because they smell even better. And I will literally only buy those spray and conditioners because it makes my hair smell nice, not because I think about using leave-in conditioner during the day. But again, on holiday, I'm constantly spraying heat protectant spray and conditioner in my hair when I'm out and about because I don't want the sun to like completely frizz up my hair. So yeah, great product. Definitely buying it from like Boots and Superdrug and even Asda, I think, have it now. The next product is a Lacoste Pour Femme perfume. This is such a nice smell. If you're like a bit of a tomboy and you're not really, really, really girly and you don't like really sweets, like florally things, and you're a little bit on the sportier tomboy side, I think you will absolutely love this. This kind of scent almost reminds me of CK1, CKB kind of scents, and it's a little bit more, not like unisex, but it's a little bit more tomboy-ish, if that makes sense. And I absolutely love this. I will definitely repurchase it, but just not yet because I've got so many other perfumes I need to get through, some of which I don't even like and I don't know why I bought them, and then I've gone and bought two of them for some reason, or some which I was going through a phase and I told people to go and buy them for me because I just wanted a backup of them and now I'm just sick of them. So this is definitely one I will go back to repurchasing because it's so yummy. Next one is my Simple Kind to Skin Soothing Facial Toner. At the moment I am using a Boots number 7 facial toner and it's really, really lovely. It kind of reminds me of this one. This one doesn't have a scent to it, but the Boots one does kind of smell clean and fresh and I do like it. Plus the Boots one comes in a bigger container, but I would definitely use this in future because it's so nice. It doesn't irritate my skin, my eyes don't sting, doesn't give you that tingly feeling, just makes your face feel really clean like after you've used it. So Simple Cleansing Toner is fantastic and I think the Simple range generally is fantastic. The last few things are, number one, okay, this is a product I haven't actually finished but I refuse to use it. It's the Care Gloss and Shine by Nivea Lip Care. It's just so goopy. I've never used a lip product that is so goopy. And to the point where I was using it just to put like in the center of my lip if I had lipstick on. And it would still like dribble down my face. And I just thought, no. It's too runny and too goopy and I just don't like it. So it is actually, to be fair, it is finished. But I think it's because half of it like leaked out. So this is something I definitely wouldn't repurchase. Nivea do some great lip stuff. This is just not one of them. This is definitely not one of them. Next one is a chapstick in Blue Crazeberry. And it came out a blue colour on your lips if you applied too much of it, which I used to do because I used to use it like before bed. And I wasn't really feeling that. I do like all chapstick lip balms. Like, I definitely love chapstick. But now I'm on this new, like, lip product search, I've actually realised other products are much, much better. So chapstick is great when you're in the car and you want something that's not effort to put on. So this actually used to stay in my car, but the original black chapstick and the medicated ones are probably my favorite ones. I'm not really into like the flavored stuff anymore. I used to be really excited about like chocolate flavored lip balm and like raspberry flavored lip balm when I was like 12 and 13. And I agree, when you're that young, like those things are really exciting. But now I just need something that's gonna heal my lips because of like the lip issues that I'm having. So definitely gonna start using products that are better for me, as opposed to one that have loads of fragrances and scents and taste really good. So no, probably wouldn't purchase that again. Next thing I really liked is the seaweed clarifying night treatment for like blemished and oily skin, and I do honestly feel when I use this regularly it does clear my skin up. So what I do, come home from work, I wash my face and I literally just to put this on my skin, and then I will might reapply it again before I go to sleep. And I have to say it does seem to like dry up the heebie-jeebies on my face. So I do really, really like this product, and I don't know if I'll go straight into repurchasing because I do have another spot product that I'm trying out, but it's still really, really great product. Body Shop stuff is just generally expensive, and I still think you can get cheaper alternatives. So wouldn't repurchase straight away, but definitely may repurchase in the future. Carmex Mint, I definitely wouldn't repurchase this again. The Carmex original is incredible, but the mint, the strawberry, and the cherry, they all have this extra like runny consistency, and the original is slightly thicker, which I really, really like. I'm not having any of this runny consistency stuff that's goopy, because you tend to find if you put it over the top of something, it just sort of bleeds, and I don't really like it. And I need something a little bit thicker on my lips, like for general purposes, I need something thicker. So yeah, I wouldn't repurchase Carmex like mint or strawberry or cherry, but definitely the original is like incredible. So these are the products I have finished. There is nothing else in my box. You can see where like this stuff has probably leaked in the bottom of this, and it's gross. I think that's the stupid Nivea lip gloss thing. But those are things I've finished recently. I hope I've given you some sort of inspiration for new products to try, and I've told you what products not to try. I am definitely going to do some sort of favourites. I might do a September favourites when I collect enough products. There's a couple of things I've really started trying and I absolutely love them, including like the face washes I'm using at the moment. And I will definitely have to make a favourites video because it's just something I've never done before. I did it at the end of like 2 years ago, but I really need to be doing them a little bit more regularly. I just can't justify doing one every month because I do not buy new stuff every single month. So yeah, these are the things I finished. I really hope this video was like useful or even slightly entertaining in some form, and I'll see you guys in the next video.